Hi folks, here's a short science video showing you how you can have some fun with magnetic fields using a horseshoe magnet or a U-shaped magnet, a keeper, and some iron filings. We'll also show you some neat stuff using ceramic magnets and neodymium magnets too. Let's begin with the horseshoe magnet. The keeper is just a piece of steel that, as you'll see, can be used to shape the magnetic field. On top of that, I'll put a sheet of plexiglass. That's to keep the iron filings from contacting the magnet directly, making a hard to clean up mess. A great way to show magnetic fields is to use iron filings, and an easy way to get iron filings is to take a piece of steel and file it using a hand file. Here I'm moving the plexiglass with the iron filings on top of it. Notice how the filings form curved lines at the end of the magnet. That's because the filings act like little magnets themselves. They line up based on the magnetic field of the horseshoe magnet. Just how much they accept the magnetic field is called their magnetic permeability. Different materials accept magnetic fields to different degrees. The molecules of air don't accept a magnetic field easily, whereas the iron filings do. One of the legs of the horseshoe magnet is the north pole, and the other leg is the south pole. So the little magnets, that is the filings, line up with their south pole attracted to the north leg, and their north pole attracted to the south leg. Since there are many filings, there are many of these little magnets. Their opposite poles attract each other, so they stick together end to end, forming lines. These lines of little magnets also space themselves apart. Their south poles repel each other, and their north poles repel each other. Wherever they're close together, the magnetic field is stronger, like close to the end of the legs. Wherever they're farther apart, the magnetic field is weaker. Here's a close-up of one end of the horseshoe magnet. Notice how the iron filings adjust to the strength of the magnetic field from the magnet below them. Now for the really interesting part. What happens if we remove the keeper? What happens is that the magnetic field in the air near the ends of the legs is much, much stronger, and so it attracts the filings more strongly. Remember, the magnetic permeability of the steel keeper is higher than the magnetic permeability of the air. So with the keeper, most of the field was in the keeper, and not much of it was in the air. Whereas with no keeper around, all the magnetic field is in the air, so it's much stronger. In fact, the field is so strong that it's able to lift the filings vertically up off the plexiglass sheet. The filings are actually showing the field in 3D. Here's a stack of ceramic magnets I got from Home Depot. As you can see, it works very well with the iron filings. To make a horseshoe or U-shaped magnet, I also picked up some steel bars from Home Depot and cut them to size. When attached to the magnet, they become a part of the magnet. I'll add some more to the other end too, to pull a magnetic field out of the air and into the steel. Otherwise, it would be too strong at the ends. And here's a stack of neodymium magnets I got from a local hardware store. As you can see, they pack a strong magnetic field into a small area. And here's a magnet I took from a computer hard drive. Notice it doesn't stick to the plexiglass, but it's so strong that the attraction between it and the filings keeps it tightly in place. Well, thanks for watching. See my YouTube channel, rimstar.org, for more fun science videos like this. That includes one on how to make a Faraday motor, a neat little science project, another showing how Franklin's bell works, another simple to make project, and one with a bunch of Van de Graaff generator demonstrations and explanations. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos, or give a thumbs up, or leave a question or comment below. See you soon!